Welcome back to Breakfast. Now for more on this unfolding tragedy that's happening on the Gold Coast, the missing teen Matthew Barclay. I'm joined by Bruce Hopkins, head lifeguard at Bondi Beach. Now, Hoppo, can you just explain for all of us how has this happened against in such a short time after Saxon Burn tragedy?
Yeah, it's definitely a tragedy, and you know, it's one of those things in the ocean. You know, it can take your life as quick as you can look at it. I see it every day down the beach, and it's something that can be, you know, very difficult, but precautions can be put in place.
Because they have put new measures in place after the tragedy in 2010. Is there a way of covering all your bases?
You know, freak accidents happen. It's hard to cover all your bases, but, you know, things can be put in place. As lifeguards, we put a massive management plan in place every day before the guys go out and work. So.
And what we're seeing just now, these are live shots coming from Currawa Beach there where this tragedy is unfolding. The search is just starting as the sun's coming up. We're going to be crossing live there very shortly. The chopper is in the air. We'll find out exactly what's happening in a short period of time. But Hoppo, can you give us some kind of sense of what the mood is amongst the surf life saving community at the moment?
Oh, they'd be very devastated, I think, the whole surf life saving movement. They don't like losing one of their own, and it's tragic for the family. And, you know, the search this morning is heart-wrenching. It'd be pretty tough. The currents move so quick up there in the Gold Coast, so the body can move, you know, 800 metres to kilometres down the beach, so it'd be very hard to find the body, but hopefully they'll find that this morning.
Yeah. What does this mean for the surf life saving movement within Australia?
Oh, I think it's definitely going to affect them in competition areas, you know, to the stage where the restrictions are going to be very, very tight, and they may, you know, it'll never be the same again, I don't think, as in the competition.
Can they go back to Currawa? Because it's almost uncanny that it's occurred at exactly the same beach.
Yeah, I mean, that's something they're probably going to have to look at. They may have to go to beaches with flat water and not go where there's significant waves that can come up.
Is age going to be a factor here? Are these championships going to have age restrictions associated?
Well, I think they'll bring things in. The big wave surfers these days use those life jackets. I think maybe, you know, everyone under 19 should have to wear those. They're still pretty, they're good these days. You can move around them pretty well.
Mm. Given your experience in this area, searching in these scenarios, can you give us a sense of what will happen today with the search?
Well, the search, they'll move the search a lot wider and move down the coast and up the coast, depending which way the currents are running, because that's which way the body has been 14 hours now. So it'll be a bigger search today. They'll have the helicopters and they'll have a lot of jet skis and everybody in there to try and find the body.
Appreciate the time this morning, Hoppo. Thank you.